Hello class, welcome back to our online discussion, and we will discuss about lawn tennis. So in a previous lecture we discussed about table tennis, and now we will discuss about the lawn tennis. So we are now in lesson 9. So lawn tennis, it is a participating in sports. It will give a lot of benefits to our health. That is why it is very important that we need to engage also in sports, so it has a benefits to our health. And then getting involved in the different sports may depend on the interest of an individual. So there are variations of people who like to play a certain sports, and then sometimes we refuse to join sports because of lack of knowledge. That is why for this particular course or subject, we will discuss about the we will focus on the individual and dual sports. And then one of the sports that is fun to play is table tennis, and there are also another thing is the lawn tennis. That is why we're going to discuss on these things. So this lesson will help you and guide you on how to play the lawn tennis, since it will discuss the nature and also the background of this sports and the proper way of playing it. So we will discuss focus on the lawn tennis. So for the objectives of this particular lesson, after going through this lesson, you are expected to appreciate the brief overview of the history of lawn tennis. You will identify the lawn tennis equipment, categorize the lawn tennis rules, demonstrate the scoring in lawn tennis, and lastly, demonstrate the lawn tennis rally. So before we will proceed to our formal discussion, we will have a pretest first. Number one, kindly prepare a scratch paper and then take your or write your answer. And we will check if you will get the perfect score or other score. So we will assess your prior knowledge about lawn tennis. So number one, which of the following is the highest governing body of lawn tennis? First, ITF or International Tennis Federation. Letter B, WTF, World Tennis Federation. C, WTA, World Tennis Authority. Or letter D, TAW, Tennis Association of the World. So among these four, what is the highest governing body of lawn tennis? But the answer for number one is ITF, International Tennis Federation. Number two, what is the length of the tennis court? A, 71 feet, B, 78 feet, C, 50 feet, or letter D, 80 feet. So the length of the table tennis court is 78 feet, letter B. Let's proceed to number three. What is the width of the tennis court? A, 30 feet, B, 36 feet, C, 28 feet, or letter D, 38 feet. So the width of the tennis court is 36 feet. Number four, what is the height of the net in the center of the court? A, 3 feet, B, 3.6 feet, C, 3.3 feet, or letter D, 2.5 feet. So the height of the net in the center of the court is 3 feet. Letter A. Number 5, what is the size of single court? A, 78 by 36, B, 78 by 30, C, 78 by 27, or letter D, 78 by 36. So the size of a single court is 78 by 27. Number 6. By the way, this is a 1 to 10 pretest. Number 6. What is size of a double court? A, 78 by 27, B, 78 by 32, C, 78 by 30, or letter D, 78 by 36. So the size of a double court is 78 by 36. Number seven, last three. In the lawn tennis, while serving the serve always has to fall in the blank. A, opposite box. B, diagonal opposite box. C, any box. Or letter D, anywhere in the opposite box. So in the lawn tennis, while serving the serve, always has to fall in the B, diagonal opposite box. Number eight, the first U.S. championship was organized in A, 1970, B, 1968, C, 1961, or letter D, 1959. So the first U.S. championship was organized in 1968. Number nine, the first French Open was organized in A, 1891, B, 1868, C, 1861, or D, 1859. So the first French Open was organized in 1891. Last number, number 10. Which of the following are the Grand Slams held every year? Which of the following are the Grand Slams held every year? A, Australian, French, Wimbledon, US Open, B, Swedish, French, US Open, or and Italian, C, Bangalore Open, Champion, US, Australian Open, or letter D, Spanish, French, US Open, Australian Open. So which of the following are the Grand Slams held every year? The answer for number 10, last number, is letter A, Australian, French, Wimbledon, and US Open. So how's your score? So congratulations to those who got the perfect score. So now we will discuss about the brief overview and the history of lawn tennis origins. So the tennis is said to have the originated in ancient Egypt. Again, it is originated in ancient Egypt. So according to the several historians, the term racket is said to have originated from Arabic word rakat, which means palm, just like this one. However, the most widespread belief is that tennis was first played by French monks in the 11th and 12th centuries. And then in 1872, when the first lawn tennis club was founded, tennis started to develop into a professional sport on the lawns of the Leamington Resort in Rua Pereira at Portuguese businessmen and doctors Wellesley Tompkins and Frederick Haynes played a Spanish game called pelota with a ball. And then later, the original lawn tennis regulations were developed in, they called it tennis on a lawn. So right now we have these sports, we called it lawn tennis. So this is the overview and history of lawn tennis. So we will discuss about Wingfield, this person. Although it is difficult to determine the exact origins of the game, it is widely acknowledged that a British Army commander named Walter Clopton Wingfield, this one, created tennis rules in 1873, eventually renaming it into lawn tennis. So, Mr. Walton Clopton Wingfield is the one who make the rules in lawn tennis. So he saw lawn tennis as having a lot of commercial potential and copyrighted it, even though he couldn't explain its invention. So Mr. Wingfield claimed to have based his game on the ideas of the Greek game, they called it Aspyrestite. from the Greek for the, this is a Greek word for playing a ball. So many experts believe he just incorporated the concept of popular English activities like as playing on courts, using squash rackets, and playing badminton in an open air. So Wingfield's game was originally referred to as tennis on the green. That is why it is called lawn tennis, playing tennis in the lawn, by early tennis players, since it was played on the green grass court. So this is the origin. Okay, so it is very important. Next is, we will discuss a bit the Lawn Tennis Association. When tennis became more profitable in the 1920s, the bulk of amateur players turned into professional. So the tennis began to expand throughout English colonies towards the end of the 19th century, first in Australia and subsequently throughout the world. So the regulations for lawn tennis in the United States were continually changing until 1991, when the USTA, or United States Lawn Tennis Association, was founded. So the regulations for lawn tennis and tournament procedures have been established by the association. So this is the association. Under the auspices of the organization, annual men's singles tournaments were conducted in Newport in 1881. And then in 1887, Philadelphia hosted the inaugural women's competition. So the first competition was played by men, and then it was in 1881. And then in 1887, it hosted for the inaugural women's competition. So after 6 years. And now we will discuss about the lawn tennis equipment. First, the ball. So the diameter of the ball shall be between 2.5 inches and 2.58 inches, and its weight is between 2 and 2.16 ounces. So this is the weight, 2 and 2.16 ounces. So the ball shall have a uniform outer surface and shall be white or yellow, but usually the tennis ball is having a yellow color ball. And also we have racket. The racket's striking surface here must be flat and consist of a pattern of crossing strings. This is a strings that is attached to a frame. So this is the frame that is alternately interlaced or where the cross with the stringing patterns being generally uniform. So the racket's frame, this one, including the handle, this one is the handle, must not exceed to 32 inches in length and 12.5 inches in width overall. And then we also have the important equipment here, the tennis bag. So the tennis bags, like every other piece of tennis equipment, are designed to provide any tennis player the most enjoyment possible, whether professional or recreational. So here's the lawn tennis rules. First, for play to continue, the ball must land within boundaries, not beyond the line of the court. So if a player hits the ball outside of the bounds, they would lose a point. It will be considered out or outside. Next, players and teams are not allowed to touch the net or cross over to other teams' side. No touching of the net. That is another rule. Number three, the ball cannot be carried or caught with the rackets by the players or team. So it is an obvious. Number four, players are not allowed to strike the ball twice. It is only once. Okay, so it is considered foul if you will hit the ball using a racket twice. Next, Players must wait until the ball has passed through the net before returning it. So the racket of the player must not go with the court of the opponent. So the player must wait for the passing of the ball before hitting the ball. Next, a player loses a point if he or she does not return a live ball before it bounces twice. So it is considered good if the ball is bouncing once in the court, but if it will bounce twice, it is no longer good. So the player will lose points on it. So the player must hit the ball before it bounces twice. Now, it is a penalty if the ball strikes or touches the players. So the ball must not hit the player. Next, a penalty is imposed if the racket leaves the player's grasp or if verbal abuse occurs. So these are the penalty. Next, any ball that bounces on the boundary lines is considered a good ball. This is an obvious rule. And then last is, before the receiving player can return a serve, it must first bounce if it is in the serving mode. Now we'll discuss about the scoring in lawn tennis. First, they call it points. The smallest measuring unit, it is called points. Points increment from, they called it love, which is also have the number 0. Okay, so the 0, we also called it love, L-O-V-E. So we have love, 0, and then 15, 30, and then 40. So there are 4. Okay, love, 0, next is 15, 30, and then 40. I forgot to put here the number. So there are 0, 15, you also have 30, and then 40. Okay. And then they also have, we call it games. Each game is worth 4 points, and a player wins if he or she scores 4 points with at least a 2-point edge. We also have, we call it set or sets. A set comprises 6 games. Again, a set comprises 6 games. And the player or the team who reaches 6 games first with at least a 2-point advantage wins the set. So there are sets here. And then we also have advantage sets. A player or a team can only win a set with 2 games lead if the game score is 6 and also the opponent has a 6 score. And advantage set rules are utilized. We also have, we call it matches. In most cases, match is played in the best of 3 or best of 5 sets. Best of 3 or best of 5 sets. And we also have, they call it juice, not Boko juice or orange juice. If you get a score of 40-40, this one, 40 for your opponent, 40 for you, you will get this, they call it juice. So if you get a score of 40-40, you will get this. And then to win the game, a person or a team must score 2 consecutive points. Okay, after reaching the 40, and then your opponent also have a 40, you need to have a 2 consecutive points to win. And a player has an advantage if they win 1 point, but if they lose the following point, the score is, they call it juice. So the question is, who serves first in lawn tennis? So there are 2 things done in knowing who will serve first in the lawn tennis. First, The toss of coin determines which player or team serves first by flipping a coin or spinning the racket. If the call is correct, the player or the team who made it gets to serve first. So the player or team who made the incorrect call selects which side of the court to play on initially. And then lastly, the rally. I think we also discussed this table tennis and also in volleyball. After the service, the rally comprises of the, not a volleyball, a badminton. Sorry. After the service, the rally comprises of the exchange of shots until a player or team makes a mistake and loses the point. This is the rally. Any shot that stays in the boundaries counts as a good shot and allowing the rally to continue. I hope that you have learned something from this short lecture about the lawn tennis, and don't forget to answer the evaluation quiz. Bye-bye. See you in the next video.